Hey there, been working for a couple hours here on the farm already today. Main project for today is getting the baseboards secured on the sides of the tunnels, which I talked about in a previous video, but we're getting that done now. We're trying to chip away at all the projects here, and it's feeling like a grind in the middle of the winter here. I mean, it's not super cold out, but you know, it's a time where you kind of just want to relax, and we got a lot of work to do. So that's what we're working on today, and I'll show you that and how we're doing that. But first, let me give you an update on a couple other things. All right, so this is tunnel one, and this is the first tunnel we built and planted, and all of these beds are now seeded, and a lot of them have come up, not all of them. Things grow, as you guys know, very slowly in the middle of the winter and also take a long time to germinate. So a lot of these beds are looking really, really great over here. So we have baby kale, arugula, spinach. We got Tokyo Bacana over here. We got some mustards. A lot of good stuff coming up, looking good. Just trying to manage this as best as possible and have realistic expectations of how long things take. But overall, really happy that this is planted and now growing. And I don't know, maybe harvest in about a month or so. We'll see how things go. This is tunnel two, obviously the second tunnel that we put together here. And it's almost fully built out. We got one bed of lettuce that we transplanted and two that were direct seeded. And we got three more beds in here that are built but haven't been planted yet. And then right behind me here, we have two beds that are partially built. So that's where we're at in here. After we finish getting the baseboards up on the bottom side here, I could probably plant two more beds, but just coming along nicely. It's just a lot of work, but things are coming along great, and these two tunnels are gonna be really productive once they're finally built and planted. All right, so I'm just off my driveway here, and I have another huge pile of metal, and as you guys can see, this is another greenhouse, and I did mention in previous videos that I needed to get a nursery greenhouse set up here, and I did get it delivered, and I will talk about this a whole bunch more because we'll be setting this up, and it is something very different from what I have now, but it's just kind of a teaser for the moment. But I did get it delivered, and let me show you where it's gonna go and a few of the details, but again, we'll get to it soon. All right, so this is where the nursery is gonna be out in this area here, and it's not gonna be a big nursery because we don't really need a big nursery. This is not a very big farm, but this is right above tunnel one. There's a little space here. Hopefully you guys can see this here. It's kind of marked out with these posts here from the chicken fencing. But yeah, it's gonna go up in this area here. Really excited about it, and I'll take you guys along for the ride. And as I said, it'll be a little bit different of a greenhouse, and it'll be a good comparison contrast with the Farmer's Friend tunnel. So let me show you what's going on in the garage. It's kind of a mess right now. So my garage is a complete disaster right now, but I just want to kind of show you where we're at with all this. And there's all sorts of stuff in here, and we'll get this all sorted soon. But one thing is the wash station, which is over here behind me, and you guys have probably seen this in previous videos. I did a bunch of content in here when I was farming here, but it's gonna go back roughly in the same place here, and I have the layout sort of roughed in now. So we have in the back there, we have the greens dryer, so it's gonna be like a 6-foot version with three fans on top. The new salad spinner, which hopefully you guys saw that video. I'm really excited about that. Got a new greens bubbler. It's a little bit larger, and it's gonna be a whole new setup, so I'll talk about that in a future video when I get to that. And then this right here is a like a double utility sink, or it's called like a utility tub. And I'm gonna use this as a little you know, root wash station. So that's kind of the main layout for the wash station. It's gonna work really well. It's gonna be a little tight, but it's just me in here working. And as I said, all this other stuff will be out of here. Right now, I still have a rack here for doing some seedlings, and this will obviously all go into the nursery greenhouse. That's the whole point of it. And then I'll also be able to move all of the soil stuff. So potting mix, soil amendments, all this stuff will be either go into the greenhouse or into the tool shed. And the tool shed right now is a disaster as well. It's half full of farming tools and half full of, you know, tools building out the farm and, you know, all that kind of stuff. So that will all have to get sorted out too. But you know, you guys know I live in the suburbs, and this property is really not meant to be a farm, and I'm just trying to make it work and use what I have and try to be really efficient with space and processes and really streamline things. And hopefully some of you guys might be in the same situation here too, so you guys can just make things work. But anyways, let's get back to the project today, which was putting baseboards on the tunnels. So let's get back to that. All right, so I talked about this in a previous video that we wanted to put baseboards in here for a couple reasons, but the main reason is that we dug these trenches out along next to each tunnel here to divert water away from the tunnels and send it downhill, which is super important. But when you have raised beds, which we built, and a ditch, there's a big difference in height here, and we don't want the soil just falling out. And also, I want to make sure that we can attach this landscape fabric to something. So I think this is going to solve a lot of those problems. And again, this is fourth inch or 1¼ inch decking boards, and they are 6 inches wide and 12 feet long. And we just sistered them together. I showed this in another video, but now today what we're doing is two things. One is we're attaching the baseboards to the hoops using these clamps here. So it's a basic, you know, strap clamp, and we order these online. I'll leave a link for them below. I haven't used them before, but that's what we're using. And so basically these just go over, and then we're gonna screw into the baseboards here. And it's going along pretty well. And then after that, we're just gonna fill in the gap between the end of the bed and the baseboard with wood chips. And it'll just give me some place to plant my foot when I'm straddling the bed. And it also just make like the whole bed surface kind of uniform and like together. And I mentioned this before, is that one of the reasons I like having wood chips in between the beds, there's a lot of reasons, but one is it just kind of keeps everything intact. Less of an issue in a tunnel where you don't have rainfall, but man, when everything's just like tight in there, it works really well. So again, we'll just fill in this gap with wood chips, and this should be, you know, pretty good. And these beds are already planted here, but more of an issue on the downhill side. As I mentioned, I was waiting to plant some of those beds. So that's what we're gonna do today, is try to get these attached and then get the wood chips in there. All right, so we got two of the sides completely done, and I'll show you that in a second. But first, I wanna talk about a couple things. First of all, I'm gonna have my first giveaway in this video, so I'll get to that in a second also. But I think the idea of working through the winter time here has been kind of wearing on me a little bit. And I know some of you guys are further north and you probably just got a bunch of snow or it's really cold and you're probably stuck inside and wish you were farming. And for me, I wish it was snowing a lot in here. I was kind of forced to suck inside, so you can't win either way. But it is nice that we have the option to push through the winter time. And you know, with that time that you guys have, maybe that you're not outside growing, prepping beds, all that kind of stuff, you're probably watching YouTube videos, reading books, doing research, all those kinds of things. It's a perfect opportunity for me to talk about today's show sponsor, which is Growing for Market Magazine. What an amazing organization they are. They've been in existence for decades and really providing lots of great content for farmers and gardeners and growers all over the place. And one thing I want to talk about with them is that the articles in Growing for Market Magazine are written by farmers that some of them have decades of experience, so way more than I have. And so it's a really good content in there. Another great thing is that it's actually a print magazine, and I think that's kind of rare nowadays. Everything's kind of digital, so it's kind of nice if you opt for that print magazine to get that delivered and you'll read it, and it's gorgeous. And so with that, you also get access to all of their archives, which is fantastic as well. So go check out Growing for Market, and if you do, there's a 25% off coupon code called SHOVEL, all lowercase. Put that in, you get 25% off a subscription. But now let's get on to the giveaway. So Andrew Mefford, if you guys don't know who he is, he's the editor of Growing for Market Magazine, also an amazing, accomplished writer, and has written several amazing books, one of which is this one, The Greenhouse and Hoop House Growers Handbook. And I've owned this book for a while, and I have recommended it before, but Andrew just sent me a copy, and I already had a copy. So let's give this away. So the way this is going to work, and I've never done this before, leave a comment down below, and just leave your Instagram username, and that way I can get in touch with you that way. But to win the contest, you have to be following myself and Growing for Market Magazine. So you follow those two, put a comment down below with your Instagram name, and I'll pick a winner by Sunday at noon. Let's call it that. Anyways, I'll send this book out to you guys. Awesome book. And if you guys are interested in this book, I'll also leave a link down below if you guys want to check it out. So with that in mind, let me show you what's been going on here and show you why we're doing this and talk a little bit more about the details. Just to demonstrate here why we're doing this, this is one we have not put the baseboard on yet. This is the bed that we built along the edge of the wall here. And as we always do, put 4 or 5 inches of compost down, and then the ditch is down here below here. So there's a huge difference in height here. And obviously gravity's gonna win here and this stuff's gonna fall down. So that's the main reason, is if we put a baseboard in here, it'll keep the stuff from going out, allow us to put a couple inches of wood chips in here that'll hold everything together. The other thing that's important here is weed control, which I talked about before, in that you gotta take your time, especially with a lot of no-till strategies, in that you take your time ahead of time to prep things so you don't have to spend time later weeding. So what we're gonna do here is once we get all this installed, we're gonna put the landscape fabric, which this is a 3.5 foot wide section, and we're gonna use a 4 foot piece of landscape fabric, and that'll come up and we can attach that to the baseboards. And then we have a surface that's completely covered because the landscape fabric will go up to the baseboard, and then the space between the bed and the baseboard will be wood chipped, and literally everything will be covered. So we'll be in really good shape there. So this is what it looks like before. Let me show you one that's completely done. So this is what it looks like all done. And another point I wanna make, one of the reasons why I wanted to do this was, this gives me that couple inches that I can put my foot down to straddle the bed. If this wasn't here, I put my foot down and it would kick all the dirt out. So I do like straddling the bed from time to time, especially when I'm transplanting, or if you just
I don't know, you move around in a tunnel, you want to put your foot down. This way, there's a place that's not in the bed for you to put your foot down. And as I push down on it, I'm pushing against the board and it'll keep everything intact. So really, really happy with this. And again, this is one of those things you spend a little bit of time with now and it pays back pretty much forever that you're working in here. So really happy with this. Anyways, gonna finish up as much as we can today. And hopefully you guys found this enjoyable, found it useful. Thanks so much for watching. Please hit the like button, hit the subscribe, and we'll see you in the next one.